Yeah, very good morning. I was just trying to wish you all students happy Children's Day. Okay. We'll start with a very interesting topic. Now, this topic, I am talking to you exclusively for the first time. Okay. So, as a third year student, you are introduced to one more type of studying material medica. Okay. So we will try to understand what is this type of materia medica I am trying to talk and what is the relevance of studying this type of materia medica. So can I quickly ask you a small question? What are all the different types of materia medica or materia medicas that you are aware of, or different ways of studying materia medica? How a materia medica is learned? Different ways of studying materia medica. Okay, so yeah, waiting for the answers to come up. Okay, so see, if you look at the evolution, and I mean probably that's what will be coming up next. See, if you look at the evolution, I'm talking to you about the homeopathic materia medica evolution. Okay, you'll see a lot of ways, a lot of methods in which our materia medica has evolved. As and how the knowledge of other sciences improved, you know, the knowledge of the knowledge of chemistry, physics, the psychiatry, all those things slowly as they evolved, our materia medica also got evolved better. Okay. See, one important way of studying materia medica, that's what I was just trying to tell you. We have different ways of studying materia medica. I'll not go into the details of all the different types, but today my focus is to tell you about a type of materia medica, or to tell you about the way a materia medica can be understood. And one such way of learning materia medica is through group study. Okay. And I was just trying to tell you, as a third year student, this method of studying materia medica is just introduced to you. So I'll spend few minutes, I'll try to tell you what exactly we understand by group study of materia medica. How is it relevant? What are all the advantages and what are all the disadvantages? And do we have a set pro forma of teaching and of course learning materia medica through this methodology? So this is what I'll be trying to do for next few minutes, and then based on this we will try to take up a very important group of remedies. Okay, so now quickly, what you students will understand at the end of the class is very important. These are my aims and objectives for today's class. Now, the first thing here, what you'll be understanding is, we'll try to understand or we'll try to list the advantages and disadvantages of studying a group study method of materia medica. That will be our first objective. And the primary focus today will be to explore the spider group. Okay, so we'll also try to recall from our pharmacy knowledge, from our forensic knowledge, what are all the common spider remedies we use in homeopathic materia medica. And most importantly, I was trying to tell you, we have a pattern. We have a pattern in which a group remedies have to be discussed. So those are all the pro forma under which I'll be explaining the spider group. Okay, so hope the objectives are clear. will quickly try to understand, or if I'll be very happy if you students contribute why group characters, what are all the advantages of studying materia medica through group characters. That is my first simple question for you, and I'll be happy if few of you can answer. Okay, very good. Majority of you students are coming up with a very important thing. A common problem that you students face is how to remember. Okay, so probably understanding materia medica through this group characters will help you remember the remedies better. Very good. And one of your friend also was trying to tell us about time saving. That's a valid point. I don't know what exactly he had in his mind when he said time saving, but it is a valid point. So one very important thing is, yeah, we'll also come to the common symptoms. Very good. Probably Pujita was talking of a point. We'll come to a conclusion of common symptoms produced by those group of remedies. Very good. Absolutely right. So I have some two or three points. This is the first point that majority of you have come up with. See, studying materia medica through group characters, they will help us in understanding the common characters of a particular group. For example, we have ophidias, we have spiders, we have mercury, we have ranunculaceae, different group. So when you're studying a group, fine, that will definitely help us to understand the common characters of that particular group. Now, why is this very important? See, I've been always trying to tell you, the exercise of studying materia medica in BHMS should directly reflect, the knowledge should directly reflect in your practice. So when you are studying a group characters of a particular group, this will definitely help us identify a particular constitution in our clinical practice tomorrow. Okay, so that is the reflection that you need to understand. It will help you to remember, and this method makes materia medica easy. The teaching and the learning both becomes very easy if you study materia medica through this methodology. Okay, you'll understand slowly what exactly I mean by this. Now, how do you make it interesting? Fine. Now, how do you make it interesting? How can a learner remember the remedy better? Now, one big advantage of studying the group character is the group. For example, Ophidias, Ranunculaceae, whichever group you are talking of, those things are very beautifully explained in physics, in chemistry, and in biology. Okay, so understanding or having a knowledge. One second, few of them are waiting. Okay. Okay, so understanding trying to correlate the basic science knowledge like physics, chemistry, biology, they help in a better understanding of these remedies. Now, with the spider, I'll try to explain what exactly I meant by this. Okay, so these are all the advantages. Now, quickly looking at the disadvantages. Any method will have its own advantages and its own disadvantages. We are looking at the advantages. Now, what could be the probable disadvantages? What could be the probable disadvantages? Okay, fine. One of your friends says probably will not get the PQRS. Okay, could be. Anything else that you can think of? We'll definitely get PQRS, not that we'll not get PQRS. See, now one very important disadvantage is the entire materia medica. Okay, Ayman has also a point, I'll come to it. The entire materia medica cannot be divided into different groups. For example, we were talking of few plants belonging to a particular family. We were talking to you about few animals belong to a particular class, or few chemicals belonging to a particular group. So the entire materia medica cannot be divided into groups. Now that's the biggest disadvantage. Now what you also have to remember here is, as a student, you are looking at this class as a student, but when you start looking at this class as a practitioner, many times we become prejudiced and we will be busy fitting up or fixing up the patient who is coming to us. We try to fix him up into some kind of a group. So we'll be always seeing if he belongs to carbon, if he belongs to ophidias, or if he belongs to some other group. So the chances of one getting prejudiced will be more. And one more very important thing is, this method will limit our knowledge. We will not think beyond. As I rightly told in the previous point, we are busy trying to fit him into a specific group. In the process, we might miss a lot of things. Okay, so we will not be able to rise up the horizon. Now, these are a few advantages and disadvantages as a teacher and as a practitioner I have felt. We can definitely add more. Fine, this is what I just felt. Okay, so we'll go ahead and we'll look at the second component. How exactly a group character should be studied? Now, how do you study a group character? So can I have some quick inputs? So in the previous slide, we spoke of the advantages and disadvantages of studying a remedy through a group. I hope that component was clear. Now we are looking at the second component of today's class. How do we study? Now this is very, very important, because this is my first class on group characters, and if you are clear, next two or three classes that I will be speaking about different groups, you will have more clarity. So any quick inputs, how a group character should be studied? Or from a teacher's point of view, how a group character has to be taught? Fine. See, now I know this is the first class. So generally, we will have a heading called as introduction, where we will be talking about the basic character of that particular group. Okay. Now I have got a few inputs coming up. Good, no problem. Under introduction, which I'll explain with a spider group. Okay. Now, after introduction, what we also look at is the two things that I'll explain together will be sphere of action and pathogenesis. From the knowledge of homeopathy, you know, each remedy will have its own characteristic individualistic area that it will affect. So the sphere of action and pathogenesis, they will become very, very important. Okay, I'll explain. Now after this, we'll be looking at the physical characters, or what we call it as the physical generals. In a group, what are all those physical generals which are common to that particular group? Okay, that is what we will try to explore. After physical generals, we can also look at the clinical indications. Probably it's not in an order, I'll put it in the order. See, now this is the order you'll have to remember: introduction, sphere of action, pathogenesis, then it will be miasm. the animation has not happened properly, so please follow the order that I am giving you. Introduction, sphere of action, pathogenesis, and the miasmatic affinity of that group. So is the group characters or is that group remedies more psoric, more psychotic, or predominantly syphilitic? Which is the miasm that is predominant? That is what we need to explore. Now, after miasms, it will be the physical generals, wherein we'll be looking at the PQRS. Okay, it could be the thermals, it could be the side affinity, it could be the thirst, it could be the desires, or it could be many more things which you will understand once I start spiders. And a group remedy will have some common mental generals. So we'll have to explore what are those common mental generals. Now, after that, we'll have to look at the modalities. As they belong to a group, they will have some common modalities, and they will also have some peculiar modalities. We'll also have to look at those common and those peculiar symptoms of that particular group and individual remedy. After modalities, we will look at the clinical indications. In which clinical condition can this particular group be indicated? From the source book, from our clinical experience, we can target this area, the clinical indication. Very important is comparison. Some group of remedies, they come very close to this particular group. So how do we compare and how do we differentiate spiders from ophidias? Okay, spiders from some other group, that will also become very, very important. That is what we call it as comparison. And the last part here, very important part, will be cases. So if at all we have some cases, I mean, I don't know as a third year student how relevant this will be, but bringing in cases will add more effectiveness to the learning, because ultimately our focus should be practice, fine? Though we as third year students, we are more worried about passing exams. Our ultimate motto should be practice. Okay, so do you have any questions here? This is a first class about how to study group remedies. If you have any quick questions, I'll be more than happy to take up the questions. If the concept is clear, if the things are clear, let's not waste time. We'll move ahead. Go ahead. All clear? Okay, yes, no, are you all there? This is the tragedy of online class. Okay, fine, good. Yeah, I'm happy. Fine, good, good. Thank you. Okay, chalo, we'll go ahead. Now, quickly, we'll look at the topic that has been assigned to me today. And what is that? Generalities of spider group. Generalities of spider group. Okay. Now, when you look at the generalities of spider group, fine. I told you we will be looking at or we'll be studying the group remedies in a different order, in a different pro forma. So the first important thing is under introduction, what information we have about spider. If you look at Wikipedia, if you open Google, you have pages of information on spiders. Now, what is that relevant information that we can pick up from the information we get it on net? So what do you students know about spiders? What should come under the heading under introduction? From your pharmacy knowledge, yeah, I have got few answers, 1 second. Okay, from your pharmacy knowledge, what is it? Okay, we'll get to know about habitat, where they live, fine, good, agreed. And we'll also get to know about the venom. Yes, very good. Now, I was always insisting that the knowledge of forensic medicine, toxicology, the knowledge of anat, physio, pharmacy, all play a very crucial role in understanding materia medica. Okay, so if you just go through the net, what we see is that there are some 40 to 47,000 species of spider on this earth, and they are very primitive creatures, fine, and they feed on insects. And as you know, all spiders will have a little amount of toxic venom, fine. Now, not all spiders can be toxic to human. Only few species like Tarantula, Latrodectus, there are few species which can be harmful. The venom can be harmful to human beings. And they belong to the class Arachnida. Under the class Arachnida, you also have scorpion, mites and ticks. Okay. And they have a good sense of touch and sight. Now, this information, what is it indirectly indicating is they are very, very sensitive. Under sensitiveness to touch, I was just checking in the repertory, you have spiders mentioned there. Okay. Fine. So, this is the basic information which you should know as a homeopathic student. They have 8 legs. Fine. And probably they're very restless, they're very fast. This knowledge of what you get from the zoology, you can also use in the doctrine of signature. The habitat, the area where it lives, its attack process. I was told, I was reading the literature, it was told spiders are very fast. Fine. How they attack, how they go, the enemy will not know. So what it is indirectly telling us is the pathology in a person who requires a spider remedy will be very fast, violent. The onset of symptoms, the onset of pathology will be very, very fast in, yes, will be very fast in spider. Now, this is how we have to correlate the information that we get on net into our materia medica. And somebody rightly said, if we study materia medica like this, we remember better. Okay, so this is the introduction about the spider. Can I quickly have a small question? Recall the spider remedies that we use in homeopathy. It's a pretty simple question. What are all the common spiders used in homeopathic? Yeah, very good. We have good. Lot of answers. Okay. Yeah, very good. So yeah. Anyway, I'll not read all those because I've just tried to get you the images from internet, taken from Google Images. Now, I've listed them from the alphabetical order, Aranea, Diadema, and we also have, I'll not ask which spider and all, unless you are a spider lover who study spider in detail, it might be difficult to give the names. Aranea, Cinacea, and this is Aranea Ixobala, and this is Mygale. And see, we also have classification of spiders into 3 different types. Latrodectus mactans, very important remedy. And this is Latrodectus catipo and Latrodectus fasciti, fine. And we also have, this is a common remedy which we use in our clinics. Commonest spider we use in our clinics is this Tarantula Hispanica. Unfortunately, I'm not sure if it is there in your syllabus. Pteridian and Tarantula cubensis is what we have in our syllabus. So at least third years you don't have this. Now, this is a very important remedy. This is what we'll be discussing in detail today, pteridium. Okay, I'll talk more about this. See, and if you just see, it's got 8 legs. Okay, otherwise, generally, I was told insects will have 3 pairs. A spider is an exception, it has got 4 pairs. Tarantula cubensis, fine. So, these are few common spiders. There could be many more. I have just taken the important spiders we use in homeopathic materia medica. So when a question on general indications or general characters of spider is asked, the first thing you do is you write few words about the introduction, okay, and you list out the common spiders we use in homeopathic materia medica. And what was the third component, if you can recall, what is the third heading under which a group remedy has to be discussed? Can somebody quickly recall? I had a box mentioned different headings. Introduction, list of remedies, good. Then we'll have to look at the sphere of action and pathogenesis. It's got a venom, and this venom, the spider venom, you know, which mainly attacks the insects, right? It is told that it is mainly a neurotoxin. So what you have to remember here is the spiders predominantly act on the nervous system. Okay? What exactly spiders do acting on nervous system is also very, very important. Okay? Now, acting on the central nervous system, you have a text which I have typed, but let me just tell it from my experience where we use the spiders. Acting on the CNS, mainly what you see is you see a lot of involuntary movements, jerky movements, chorea, fine, hysteria, beautiful remedy for hysteria. And when you're looking at a higher pathology, you can also see convulsions in this particular remedy. So to just mention, what you need to understand here is it is a remedy. One second, there are few are waiting. Unlock meeting. Okay. Iman has something to contribute. Now what you need to understand here is you see this remedy or the spider group mainly indicated for all the movements that I've tried to show you here, fine. Involuntary movements, chorea, ptosis, twitchings. It's not ptosis exactly, it is twitchings, or it could be convulsions, or you have another very important thing that I have mentioned here, and this is hysteria. Okay, so I have just tried to give you a description that the venom mainly acts on the motor nerves. Okay, and you also have remedies, spider remedies, acting on the sensory nerves. And one remedy I want to highlight here is pteridium. Has a beautiful action on the sensory nerve. We'll discuss that a little later. So the first sphere of action and pathogenesis of a spider will be on CNS. Okay. Now, I've also tried to make things a little more clear for you. Out of so many spiders that I've mentioned, which are the spiders which mainly act on the nervous system? Okay. So now the spiders which have an affinity for nervous system are Tarantula, Pteridion, Mygale and Aranea. These are few spiders which mainly acts on nervous system. I was looking into the repertory. There is a rubric called as neurological affections. And I was looking for all the spiders. And these are the spiders mentioned under that rubric. And if you also read the Materia Medica, you will see that these spiders, they have very good action on the nervous system. Similar to nervous system, you also have spiders predominantly acting on bones. Okay. Now this is where the miasm plays a very important role. Bhagyashree had mentioned a little while ago that she was talking of syphilitic miasm. Now, what is that that will justify the miasm in spiders? If it has to be syphilitic, what should be the action of spiders on bones? A simple question for you. What should be the action of spiders on bone to justify the fact that it is predominantly syphilitic in nature? I hope the question is clear. Yeah, very good. Yes, good. Probably Roshini and who's this? There's some issues. But anyway, now what you need to understand is, yes, good. Destruction, caries, necrosis. So under caries bones, you have the following remedies mentioned in your repertory, which is also confirmed in your Materia Medica. Pteridion, Tarantula, Arania are few remedies which affects the bones. Okay, and it will cause necrosis, very important. Spiders, not only nerves, bones, you see spiders also acting on the heart. Okay, so it will cause constriction of the muscle fibers. Yeah, cardiac muscle fibers, circular and cardiac muscle fibers. So remedies which predominantly act on heart, you will get to know a little later, focus on the class. Remedies, spider, they also act on the blood, causing blood poisoning or destruction of RBCs. Septic conditions, septicemia, it will cause septicemia. Okay. So blood poisoning, you predominantly have the symptom in Tarantula cubensis, Tarantula hispanica, and Tarantula hassali. These are three predominant spiders which can cause blood poisoning. From my practical experience, Tarantula cubensis is a beautiful remedy for septicemia. Okay. The miasm, which majority of you have come up with, predominantly psychosyphilitic. The miasmatic background of a spider group of remedies will be psychosyphilitic. Any questions till now? Any clarification? Anything you want me to repeat? So what have we spoken here is, I've just introduced you to the spider group, and we have tried to understand the common spiders we use, the sphere of action and pathogenesis. Okay. Now we look at the mentals. Yeah, can somebody quickly think of the probable mental symptoms or mental characters that we have in Ayman was quick like a spider, you know. I mean, that's the beauty of spider. They're very quick. Good. Yeah. Once I said quick like spider, a lot of remedies are coming up. I mean, a lot of answers are coming up. Good, very good. All right, very good. All absolutely fine. Good, keep it up. Now, what you see is understanding the spider. You know that they have eight legs, and they're very restless creatures, and they're very cunning. You know, I was reading the article in the net, and they say how they attack the enemy. If you just see some YouTube videos, you'll be surprised how quick they are, how cunning they are. Fine. So very fast, very cunning. Okay, probably some images will come. Must be, you'll understand better with images. Yeah, I was talking to you about they being very restless. Okay, overexcited, restless, hurried kind of people. So in clinics, we have patients who are very hurried. Now, I told you, you know, when I told you about the disadvantages of studying a remedy through group. See, when I say hurried, It's not only tarantula. We have so many other remedies which are hurried. So you should have an idea about other remedies also. So basically, they are hurried constitutions. Okay, they're very restless. Yeah, you see them. You know, they're very, very restless. Tarantula is a remedy commonly used for ADHD. Okay, autistic children, hyperactive children, tarantula is used. I use tarantula Hispanica specifically very often in my clinic. But today I don't know if I have time to share cases because you are all busy with exam preparation. So we'll try to focus on the important points that will help you in your exams. Cases must be some other day. I'll discuss cases. Okay. So hurried, restless, and very, I put fox here. And what does fox denote? I mean, many times we say this guy is very foxy. That lady is, a fox denotes, sly, cunning. We have a cunning fox. We have a sly fox. Stories on fox. So spider remedies are very cunning. Okay. They're deceitful. And talking about deceit, one more area that you can see deceit in spiders will be women or the men being adulterous. The men being adulterous. Okay, so I've also tried to give you the list of other remedies so that I don't have time to explain all those things, but you should know. And angry constitution, irritable, angry, and spiders have strong fear of death. Strong fear of death. Okay. And very nervous. Fine. Very hysterical. Angry. Very emotional. Very restless. Deceitful. Cunning. These are the common mental characters that will come to our mind when we think of a spider. Okay. So, there are plenty of mentals, but we are talking of the generals. The general mentals of spider. So that is what you need to remember. So after the mental generals, we'll try to focus on the physical generals. Okay. Under physical generals, I am directly starting with the desires of spiders. Okay. Generally, spiders, they like more of sand. Sand. You see the image there. Silesia is also another remedy we should remember. They also have desires for vegetables. Sulfur, abyssinian, magnesium sulf. Desires banana. Very few remedies in our Materia Medica. And which is that one spider which has desire for banana is pteridian. Okay. Pteridian. We'll discuss pteridian a little later. And you also have another very important thing here is tuberculinum. We have many tubercular kids coming to our clinic, very hyper kids. Many times we get confused with tarantula. Okay. Tuberculinum, hemamelis, podophyllum, a few more remedies which have desire for banana. And oranges. Desires oranges. Again, one top spider is pteridian. We'll discuss it a little later. Other remedies, I've just listed it out. You can have a look. So sand, vegetables, fruits, especially banana and oranges. And I was trying to tell you about the pathology. Acting on nerves, you see them causing all those involuntary movements, the jerky movements, involuntary movements, hysteria, fine, twitchings. Okay. And I've also tried to mention the remedies which mainly cause the involuntary movements. Migale, Tarantula hispanica, Tarantula cubensis are few remedies which acts on the muscles causing twitchings, chorea. Okay. One more physical general of a spider is periodicity is very much marked. Okay, what is periodicity? What is what is periodicity? Hope my voice is clear. Yeah, what is periodicity? Like symptoms will come up at a particular time. Now we'll try to understand which are the spiders which has periodicity. Tarantula hispanica, where symptoms come at the same hour every day. Okay, Tarantula cubensis, intermittent fever which comes up at the same hour. Aranea diadema, very nice remedy which we generally use for intermittent fevers. So chills coming at same hour every day or every other day. Aranea tella, I have never used this, you know, from the way how I am pronouncing. Aranearum tella, I have never used, but anyway. Periodicity, wherein they get periodic headaches. Periodic headaches. So these are few spider remedies which have predominant periodicity. Okay. So before we continue, what I was trying to tell you is, we looked at the mental common characters or common symptoms, common mental symptoms in spider. Then we are discussing the physical generals. Under that, I told you about the periodicity. Okay. We also spoke about, the twitching, the neurological affections, the desires. We spoke about the desires. Okay. Now we look at the side. Pteridion, Tarantula, Hispanica, Cubensis, Latroductus, Mactus, and Latroductus, Calipo. They are all more mainly left-sided. Aranea, Diadema, and Mygale are predominantly right-sided. Okay. Now again, if you read spider in Wikipedia, fine. It is told that there's a lot of sexual activity, and majority of the spider patients who require spider remedy, they'll have increased sexual desire. The sexual desire in them will be more. For example, Tarantula, Mygale, Pteridion are few remedies which has increased sexual desire. And again, they have an affinity for heart, which I just explained. Latroductus, Tarantula, Hispanica, Pteridion, Mygale, Latroductus, and Tarantula, Hispanica. Few remedies which can alter the functioning of the heart. You see rapid pulse, very rapid pulse, to the extent that pulse might go up to 130, 140 in Latroductus mactans. Okay. Anginal pains, these are few common things you see in spider. Okay. Yeah. Rapid pulse. And a lot of sleep disturbance you see in spider remedies. To name few, we have Aranea diadema, Latroductus, Tarantula cubensis, Hispanica, Pteridion, they all have sleep disturbances. Okay. In Pteridion, late sleep in mornings bites tongue in sleep. Tarantula cubensis, sleep prevented by harsh cough. Okay. These are a few examples. In Latroductus, SLT, sleeplessness in malignant septic conditions. Okay. So, spider remedies can also have hemorrhages. Very few remedies have. From the repertory, we have Aranea, Diadema, and Latroductus, Mactans. Two spider remedies which can have hemorrhages. Hemorrhages which mainly comes from uterus and lungs, and the hemorrhages are black and non-coagable. And they're very chilly. If you look at the thermals, they can't tolerate cold. They want to be very, very warm. Except Tarantula cubensis and Aranea, all other spiders are chilly spiders. Hot, thermally hot spiders are Tarantula cubensis and Aranea. Okay. Now we'll come to the modalities. Must be in 2 more minutes. We may have to close the class. Bright objects, touch, noise, light, coition, during and after menses, they all aggravate. Smoking, rubbing and music, they ameliorate. Smoking is very important and very prominent in Aranea, the spider Aranea. And the clinical indications, where can a spider be indicated? See, this I'm not giving too much of importance because you know homeopathy is symptomatic, fine, and we match the symptoms. So any symptomatology that is included in the drug, and if it is there in that particular patient, you can give a spider remedy. I'm generalizing it because we have wonderful results in our clinics using spider remedies for different conditions. But as a third year student, you should also know that the common clinical indications where a spider can be thought of. It could be septicemia, hemorrhages, bone caries, chorea, convulsions, hysteria, menstrual irregularities, palpitations, sleep disorders, asthma, behavioral problems, depression, etc., etc. The list will go on and on. It depends how nicely you have understood the spider and how well you apply in your clinical practice. Okay, so this is all related to